I want to wish everybody a happy new year, and I want to concur with Commissioners Hewitt and Colvin and say that Mako was a fantastic experience. It was quite the information overload on the second day. First day was pretty easy. It was just the newly elected guys. But I like to think that I've made a lot of connections throughout the state, and you got a really in-depth view of what various state agencies and county agencies do and how they can intertwine to work for the good of the counties. In fact, I think I made one particular connection that may have direct economic impact on the county. I should know something on that within the next week or so. And being able to interact with other county administrators, other commissioners, other council members throughout the state really opens up your eyes once you get out of the bubble of St. Mary's County of just how much we're all struggling with vacancies and trying to find people to fill these jobs. Like Commissioner Hewitt said, we're going to keep striving to fill these positions to serve the county. And I also want to also share my congratulations with Commissioner President Guy and another round at as board of director. It is quite the like I said, it was quite the event, and not a whole lot of talk of politics between parties, but a lot of how can we do what's best for our individual counties. And something to pass on to our Rec and Parks Department, I was talking to Liz Fitzsimmons, who is the State Director of Tourism. She had nothing but praise for our park system in this county, and is really looking forward to coming down and seeing our new waterfront parks, and say that she's very happy that there's counties in the state who are opening up waterfront parks. And I encourage all of you to go out there and visit all of our parks, and especially our two new waterfront ones as soon as they are open. And I look forward to a prosperous, strong year for 2023 for St. Mary's County. Thank you.